All right, guys. So I had mentioned it last night in my team building guide, if you didn't pay attention to all the way towards the end, for the ultimate Gohan on the JP side, that this Gohan was going to be getting a Dokkan Awakening, and I was going to be focusing on a video today. So that's what we're working on right now. We're going to go ahead. We're going to talk about the card. We're going to talk about his Dokkan Awakening. The cool thing about him is he actually works really, really well on an ultimate Gohan team. He's a mixed Saiyan, and he has Shocking Speed, and he has Z-Fighters. So those are two Link skills that are really needed, Shocking Speed for the key links for Ultimate Gohan, and Z-Fighters is one of the rarer links that the Ultimate Gohan would like to get hit off for a 15% attack buff. The other one's not so much, but he is viable with other cards for linking. Let's go ahead and talk about the base form first before we talk a little bit more about that. Inherited Mission, Super Saiyan 2, Gohan Teen. His original leader ability, all types key, plus 2. Super attack with Super Kamehameha, supreme damage to the enemy. Passive skill, Furious Strike, all allies attack, plus 2,000 when key is 5 or more. Link skills, Golden Warrior, Saiyan Warrior Race, Super Saiyan, Z-Fighters, Shocking Speed, and Kamehameha. Max stats are HP of 7928, attack of 7922, and defense of 3884. You know, weird, a little bit of a lower defense for a physical character, but I believe he's a little bit older anyway, in terms of cards. And he has a 12-key multiplier of 145%, which is actually not bad, all things considering. He does Dokkan Awakening now with 7 medals, the Warrior Mark Super Saiyan Gohan 2 medals. Those are going to be available from the Hero Extermination Plan Evil Power Strike Back event. I believe it was like level 13. Yeah, level 13, Devastating True Power. That's where the medals actually drop from. So you're going to want to go ahead and grind that out. I believe it's on the weekends. Forgot what day. Like I think it's both days. But that's when this event is available, is on the weekends. So when you see this image come up on the JP side, or hey, even the global side, if you want to, you know, get ready in advance, go ahead, grind those medals out. He Dokkan Awakens into Pride of the Strongest Fighter, Super Saiyan 2 Gohan Teen. New leader abilities, all types, key, plus 3, HP and attack, plus 40%. Super attack, Super Kamehameha, greatly raises attack for one turn and does supreme damage to the enemy. That's really good. I really like that. Essentially, well, the way I see it is greatly raises attack is super attack 10 immense damage modifier. I don't know. That's just the way I look at it. It's not actual math there. I don't have the math to tell you actually how much that actually, you know, increases the attack. Passive skill, Fiery Morale, all allies attack and defense plus 35%. This is another reason why he does really well on an Ultimate Gohan team. So I don't actually have it up, but if you want to go ahead and take a look, I did all of the support units. He is now going to be in some of the top support units. I kind of see him being alongside the Super Saiyan 2 Gohan from the World Tournament rewards. Actually, you know what? We'll go ahead and we'll bring that up. So essentially, I think that this card is super viable. Unfortunately, he doesn't give any key, which is kind of needed on an Ultimate Gohan team, just because Ultimate Gohan will not get really a lot of super attacks off because his only real good link skill is Shocking Speed. But let's see, this is Super Saiyan Gohan Teen. So that actually works out really well because this one's Super Saiyan 2 Gohan Teen. So you could actually run these two on the same exact team without having any issues. Now this is the guy I was talking about. Super types, key plus 2, attack and defense plus 25%, super viable. This guy is just like, it's good. He's really good. All allies attack and defense plus 35% with no restrictive or anything like that. He would probably be one of the top that I would recommend because he is Super Saiyan, because he has Shocking Speed, because his passive boosts attack and defense of all of his allies. he has Z-Fighters, which gives a 15% attack buff to the Ultimate Gohan when he's paired with him. Overall, not a bad unit. I really like it. It's really easy to get Dokkan Awakened. Unfortunately, he doesn't have Fierce Battle because he Dokkan Awakens with the Hero Extermination Plan medals. So that's why he gets Shattering the Limit. But that makes him a little bit more viable on Super Saiyan 2 or Super Saiyan Super Saiyan 2. On LR Trunks team, he does get hit off those links with him. So that way he makes him a little bit more viable. I believe he actually gets the TUR Gohan. Yeah, that's it. So the TUR LR Gohan, the TUR variant of him. He'll hit off 2 key there if you don't have yours at LR at that point. But overall, that's what it is, guys. Really useful card. I like the fact that he finally got a Dokkan Awakening. I know we've been waiting for that for a long time. He becomes super useful, super viable. I recommend running him as a support unit for almost... Actually, he can run on almost any team. Does really well on a super team just because it's all allies. It's unrestricted. So essentially, you could really throw him on whatever team you wanted. But in terms of, you know, where he's going to benefit the most, it's going to be monophysical, a hero team, monophysical in general, and mono hero team. So that's where he's going to get the most use out of. But thank you for joining me here today. Want to go over that quickly. Hit that subscribe button if you're new, and I'll catch you guys later.